In this lesson, we'll take a look at one algebraic proof and three possible combinatorial proofs for the binomial identity n choose k equals n choose n minus k. For the algebraic proof, if we apply the factorial definition for n choose n minus k, we have n factorial divided by the product of n minus the quantity n minus k factorial and n minus k factorial. From here, n minus the quantity n minus k simplifies to k, giving us a denominator of k factorial times n minus k factorial. Using the commutative property multiplication, we have n factorial divided by the product of n minus k factorial and k factorial, which is the factorial definition for n choose k. And now let's look at three possible combinatorial proofs. Explanatory proofs are typically called combinatorial proofs. In general, to give a combinatorial proof for a binomial identity, say A equals B, we do the following. Number one, we find a counting problem to answer in two ways. Number two, we explain why one answer to the counting problem is A. Number three, we explain why the other answer to the counting problem is B. Since both A and B are the answers to the same question, we have A equals B. Let's look at the first combinatorial proof. N choose k counts the number of ways to select k things from n choices. On the other hand, n choose n minus k counts the number of ways to select n minus k things from n choices. Are these really the same? Well, what if instead of selecting n minus k things, you choose to exclude them? How many ways are there to choose n minus k things to exclude from n choices? Clearly, this is n choose n minus k as well. It doesn't matter whether you include or exclude the things once you have chosen them. If you exclude n minus k things, then you are including the other k things. So the set of outcomes should be the same. Therefore, n choose k equals n choose n minus k. And now let's look at a second combinatorial proof. For this combinatorial proof, we use the pizza counting problem we used before. How many ways are there to pick k toppings from a list of n choices? On one hand, the answer is simply n choose k. Alternatively, you could make a list of all the toppings you don't want. To end up with a pizza containing exactly k toppings, you need to pick n minus k toppings to not put on the pizza. You have n choose n minus k choices for the toppings you don't want. Both of these ways gives you a pizza with k toppings. In fact, all the ways to get a pizza with k toppings. Thus, the two answers must be the same. N choose k is equal to n choose n minus k. And let's take a look at one more possible combinatorial proof. For the last combinatorial proof, we could use bit strings, subsets, or lattice paths. Let's go ahead and use bit strings. N choose k counts the number of bit strings of length n with k ones. This is also the number of bit strings of length n with k zeros. Just replace each one with a zero and each zero with a one. But if a bit string of length n has k zeros, it must have n minus k ones, and there are exactly n choose n minus k strings of length n with n minus k ones. Therefore, n choose k must equal n choose n minus k. I hope you found this helpful.